let's talk about puberty in girls today. As during puberty, your body is going under a lot of changes, leaving you confused with what is going on. Puberty is a phase of physical development. Once you enter into puberty, your breasts begin to develop, your body shape becomes curvier, new hairs start to grow under your arms and pubic areas. Soon you will have your first period, vaginal discharge may start. These changes are preparing you for adulthood. Usually, breast development is the first evidence of puberty. When you get your first period, it also symbolizes that your body is now ready to get pregnant. So when does puberty start? Ideally, girls' puberty starts between the ages of 10 and 16. But if there are no signs of breast development by the age of 14, or you have not got your first period by the age of 16, then it may be considered as delayed puberty. In other scenario, if you have had signs of breast development, pubic hair growth, or had your first period at the age of 7 or 8, then it's considered as precocious puberty. If you notice signs of delayed or precocious puberty, then talk to your parents or guardian about it and seek medical attention. Along with physical changes, you will also notice a number of psychological and behavior changes, like mood swings. Emotionally, you'll become very intense and sensitive. You might have more sexual thoughts. You will also become more conscious about yourself. All such changes are totally normal once you hit puberty. Another major change that you will notice is body odor, as your sweat glands become active during puberty. And it becomes very important to follow a good personal hygiene routine to keep yourself odor-free and feel fresh and clean. You might notice sweat and odor under your arms, pubic area and feet. Best way to get rid of this is to take shower daily and change your clothes and underwear every day. Prefer to wear cotton clothes which will allow your body to breathe. You can also use a good deodorant with antiperspirants. During puberty, oil secreting gland becomes overactive. Because of that, your hair looks shiny and greasy. To control that, you should wash your hair daily or every alternate day. Use warm water and don't rub roots too hard. Acne is a term used to describe skin problems like pimples, blackheads, whiteheads. Acne is most common between the ages of 14 and 19. Keep your face clean and fresh by washing it twice a day. Avoid touching it unnecessarily. Don't squeeze your pimples. Try to use herbal or chemical-free products for your face and skin. You will see new hair growing in different areas of your body, like your underarms, legs, pubic area. It is important to keep good hygiene of pubic hair by washing it regularly with water. If you want to get rid of these hair, waxing is considered as long-lasting, inexpensive, and the safest method for hair removal. During periods, you must follow good menstrual hygiene habits as well, which does not only include keeping yourself clean, but also includes selecting the right product, disposing it off properly, using it properly. There is a very common myth that says we shouldn't bathe or wash our hair during periods. However, to maintain hygiene and freshness during menstruation, you should have a bath regularly. Wash your hands with soap before and after changing your pad or menstrual cup. Wash your genital area every time you use the toilet. It helps to stop menstrual odor or infection. Vagina is the most sensitive part of your body. Always use the right way to clean it. Wash your genital area with warm water externally. After using the toilet, wipe from front to back to avoid any kind of urinary or yeast infections. A large variety of sanitary products like pads, tampons, menstrual cups, and reusable cloth pads are available in the market. You should do your own research, take a look at the pros and cons of each before making a decision. It is important to change your sanitary product on time. Practice to change it every 4 to 5 hours, even if it's not full. Continual use of same sanitary pad or tampon can increase your risk of infection. You must know the right way to dispose used sanitary product. Never throw it in the open without wrapping, and do not flush it down the toilet. Thanks for watching.